Okay, so fall restraint is a like a subcategory of fall protection. Some people call it travel restrict or travel restraint, but what they really mean is fall restraint. And you can be in a class one belt for fall restraint, it's perfectly fine. At its bare bones, the intent of fall restraint is to, it's not to arrest a fall, it's to prevent you from falling over the edge. So by that implication, it kind of means that you need to have your line taut at all times. From the basics, you can improvise this with just a rope or cord. I wouldn't want to go anything less than 8 mil, typically, in diameter. So here, I just have an 11 mil rope. I've set it, and so if you can pan the camera on the floor, that's like kind of the end of my rope is my edge right there. And so I've sized it up, and I've tied a stopper knot down there already. And then I brought it back. I brought it back, sized it up, and just did a bowline with a bite and, you know, somebody retrace finish just to give me some options at the anchor. And I've also constrictor hitched it while I was tying it so that it doesn't drop down the bollard. So you can constrictor hitch any knot you tie around an object to keep it from sliding. But I'm at its basic form, I just need something that I can adjust as I travel. And usually you don't want to grab it with your hand. You kind of want to beat it on the backside. It can get kind of tough, but within reason. I just grab this and walk down with it until I get close to the edge. And when I'm close to the edge, that's when I want to be very careful about what I grab. Because if I slip and I panic and I grab the prusik, it's not going to engage and I could go over the edge. So as I go back, I've set my max distance and the edge is here. And really, even if the edge was up here, and I have a lot of slack in my system, I'm gonna fall over the edge if I don't maintain constant, somewhat semi-taut tension. So this kind of needs to be back here. And when I lean back, like it's gonna prevent me from actually going over the edge, hence fall restraint. It's not gonna let me fall over the edge. And that's an important concept, an important key principle, is you want minimal to no slack in your system when you build this. You don't need to tie the end into yourself, because all that does is create this loop, and you tend to get snag. It tends to snag up on things, and people trip when you size it up and then tie this end with a big bite hanging down. That's overkill. It's actually less safe, in my opinion. So you just leave it at that. The Aztecs or the set of fours have the personal side end. Not the mechanical advantage side. You can see that, okay? So here, what I did, and the Purcell prusik is just a fancier prusik. It's like a prusik on a prusik. So this is my kind of tether, my adjustability right here, and I can go back. What I don't want to do, or what I want to avoid doing, is zoom in, Haley, is when I clip around an object like this, when I just wrap around and clip in, the connectors and the carabiners, they weren't designed when I choke up to be side loaded. That's side loading right there, not cross loading. So these weren't designed to be side loading, and I want to avoid doing that when possible. And so a better alternative, oftentimes, is going to be instead of just clipping it, you can do like a butterfly, or you can do like a clove hitch. Here, what I'm going to do is zoom in close for this. I'm going to do an Italian or a Munter hitch. And so I clip in, set where I kind of want. I don't want this to be butt up against here, but I clip in, and then I twist and feed a bite in. And now you can see that that's your classic Italian hitch or Munter hitch. And now it's not going to go anywhere, and this carabiner is not going to get side loaded. So that's a good way. There are a bunch of ways to do it, but that's a really fast and slick way to do that. So let's move on to the other Aztec. So here, we kind of did the same thing, except this is a bollard. And so I constrictor hitched it. And really, I can get away with this now, because really what I'm pulling on is the constrictor hitch on my fall restraint lanyard. This carabiner is not doing anything. It's really the constrictor hitch that I'm weighted on. So I can get away with just clipping it in on around the backside. Or I could just leave this out. This is not really that important. I could just weight the constrictor hitch and be okay. And this will guide me back. Let's say that my anchoring options, I didn't have very good anchoring options, but I have an Aztec. And I'm not the only person doing edge work. somebody else is going to come in. I may go away, get a drink of water, whatever. Do some other type of rigging somewhere else. And so what I can do is just take a line, like a rope, and extend it out. And let's just say that this is no longer my edge. Let's just say that my edge is like another like 30 feet in that direction out there. And so what I can do is just take a rope at a reasonable distance and then just, whatever, just tie a carabiner or just tie a loop in here. It doesn't even matter. It can be anything you want it to be. In this case, I'm just going with a barrel noose. And now each person that comes to work or does whatever they're gonna do, they can just extend on their Aztec to that point, do their work at the edge with whatever they need to do. And then when they're done, and they want to go somewhere else and do some other rigging task, they come back, they get their gear, they unclip, and this Aztec stays with them and they go on to do other things. So that's another option. So I mentioned in some other videos that the Purcell Prusik, or any kind of Prusik or friction hitch, is kind of like a compromise. Unless it's like a VT, they're really cool. So you could use anything that's appropriate. How much you're gonna invest, that's up to you. A regular Prusik or a Purcell costs, I don't know, like nothing practically, but this doesn't. This costs like $100. And what this is just, it's basically like a positioning device. It's not a Grillon lanyard. It's not a Grigri. It's not an ID. But what's great about it is that it doesn't have, let me take this out. There is no spring in here. The Grigri is a terrible idea if you want to do some sort of fall restraint work positioning, because the Grigri, the cam on the Grigri wants, there's a spring in there and it wants to stay open all the time. So the second you unweight it, and you're gone. You need to have that strong force rapid action to engage the cam, but the second you detension it, it just slides through. These don't do that because there's no spring in here. It tends to want to stay put. So this is kind of like the next best thing you can get. The Grillon lanyards are awesome, but you can't really use those because they're like an integrated device. With they're sealed. This I can move anywhere. The Madrox Safeguard. They don't make very many things in the market, but this is one of them that is made. That is small, compact, lightweight, and it has no spring in it, and makes for great work positioning. So I can just depress the cam, drag myself out where I want to work, and I let go of the cam, it waits when I weight it, and then when I unweight it, it stays, and I can tension it, detension it, tension it again, it stays put. If this was a Grigri, and I initially weighted on the Grigri, the second that I unweight on a Grigri, this cam wants to open up, and then if I go out again, depending on the angle of this, it will not lock up again. Like, you have to kind of do one of these on the Grigri because it's an assisted blade device for that cam to engage. Here, I can just leave this loose anywhere and it'll stay put. So a lot of options for fall restraint, a lot of things you can substitute for like a Prusik or a Purcell Prusik. It's just limited to your imagination, where you're shopping, what your budget is. But this is cool too because I can also descend with it as well.